CVVN Nightly News Bulletin, this 25th of October, 2031.
Today, a decade on, we look back to 2021, reflecting on the year the Australian government finally fixed our political donations laws and remembering how bad they were. I mean, thank God the Australian people finally started to think more about who was giving their politicians money when that minister resigned because he couldn't tell the public who had donated to his blind trust. Which was different because a lot of the time the politicians knew where their donations were coming from, but it was the public who didn't. Talk about blind trust. But that wasn't the only thing that made people a bit sus about the level of influence that lobbyists and donors had in Canberra. Remember when we responded to COVID-19 by putting together a national COVID-19 coordination commission, which had quite a few people with links to the gas industry who, strangely enough, decided the best way to deal with a pandemic was to subsidise gas companies. Not that that was any surprise once we saw how much money and access these guys were kicking in to both of our major parties. And it wasn't just gas. There was millions flowing in from big consultancy firms, there was the gambling lobby, the property developers, the unions, the gun lobby. Yep, can you believe we had one of those too? Who, per capita, were as cashed up as the NRA? Yes, back then, everyone was kicking in to ensure the arms race for political donations kept growing for all involved.
You got two major political parties in this country that pretty much have the thing locked up. Both of them have to try and be in competitive range of each other when it comes to fundraising. It becomes an arms race.
What do you think, Sharon?
Thanks, Christian. That's hilarious. I can't believe people used to put up with that. Or the fact that our parliament once had way more lobbyists than politicians, who had their own special passes that gave them privileged access to the corridors of power. Not to mention the fact that we had worse donations transparency than even America.
Oh, that's crazy. Moving on, in more current political news, since getting full transparency and caps on donations and election spending, there have been fewer dodgy donations received by politicians. And thanks to new truth in political advertising laws, our parties aren't involved in spreading lies aimed at dividing the nation. And decisions are finally being made in the best interests of the people. Plus, with less money coming in from the top end of town, politicians are forced to spend more time trying to make their electors happy and actually run the country, instead of hosting those antiquated fundraising dinners for which business people would pay thousands of dollars to sit next to a politician of their choosing. It's just crazy that used to happen when you think about it. Now to weather, how's it looking, Jim?
Nothing out of the ordinary there, Christian. Just, you know, your usual floods, bushfires, hailstorms, and the other bunch of once-in-a-lifetime weather events. Of course, a catastrophic heat wave burning its way across Australia.
Right. Yes, I'd have thought that those new donations laws would have fixed that problem.
Oh yeah, you know, maybe if we had done that 40 years earlier.
Is that a bomb?
Oh no, that's an earthquake. Sorry, should have predicted that.
Moving on now to sports news, and F45 gyms have finally been made officially a cult.